Billy, you had myself and Brandon that operate correctly. You dumb fuck, you just had to wait.
Well, I mean, to be fair, I was already established with them prior to meeting you guys.
Yes, but you can... You say to them, for Sonia and Kirk, simply, all I'm going to do is we're going to sell crowbars. I'm not selling blueprints. You're selling the blueprints, absolutely fucks the market and floods it, right? If you guys are selling crowbars, different. Selling fucking blueprints is going to flood it and fuck it.
I wanted to sell crowbars, but they brought up, you know, I'm not in a position to do that, right? You know, especially after getting robbed. Like, you know, my house got broken into. Like, I can't just start producing crowbars. They found a fucking perfectly brand new one on the bench. Like,
Billy,
what do you think that means?
Billy,
like,
Billy. Billy. You go find yourself a material supplier and you say, I will supply you with crowbar. Whenever you need it, you supply me with materials.
That's what me and Brandon were doing. But then it fell through. You know, his material person's his material person. They'll work with him. I don't know if they'll work with me. I don't have the sources he has, okay? But then also on top of that, I'm stuck with a bunch of crowbars and I have to figure out who I'm selling these crowbars to.
I can find you at least four people that can flog off crowbars for you very easily. And they're very decent fucking people to work with.
Every time I've tried to work with somebody, it's just this one giant jerk off session of just hours and hours of like, let's do this, and it just never pans out. So Brandon didn't want to do it. I went to, you know, somebody else with the same offer. And I don't even know if it's panning out. It's very weird.
Okay. What is a blueprint cost price for you?
5,000.
The inclusive of tax I'm talking about.
Sorry, what did you say?
Cost price inclusive of tax.
5,680.
All right, so 5,700.
Yeah. Basically.
Now, how much? So you said that you had Sonya selling. How many did you sell? Two.
We sold two. We only delivered.
And how much
one
for?
So 30,000.
And they both have paid you.
Both have paid. Yep.
And how much is Sonya getting out of it?
Nothing.
So you're getting the full price back.
Yeah, they didn't ask for anything. They did it just to help me sell them because that's what they wanted.
Right. Now, do you know who that they've sold them to?
Yeah.
Okay. Who have they sold them to?
Reggie, I can't tell you that.
Tell me this because it's going to change what I'm going to tell you to do because it can potentially have fucked the market already. Not like I'm going to go spouting off to other people about
fucked.
It.
At this point, the market's fucked, man.
So they sold them to dumb people.
Yes, they did. Oh, they sold them to people I didn't want them to.
Oh.
Basically the one person in the city that will ruin the market.
Holy shit, Billy.
The other person, they said they're getting a bench shortly and then they'll take it, right? But they prepaid. But the one that's got delivered on is, you know, give me a guess.
Either Larry or Jamal?
Nope, it's neither of those. So then maybe it's not that bad.
Well, at least those two are business minded.
Did you say Larry?
Tell me it didn't get sold to Dundee.
No, he works at Popular.
Okay, then who is it?
Have crowbars on.
Who is the dumbest person in your opinion that it got sold to?
Well, Mary Munchkin.
Okay, that's not that bad, actually.
Yeah, well, I mean, have you been following the war between...
Yes, I know there's going to be a war back and forth about that ship. That's not as bad as it could be, trust me.
She basically wants the blueprint as a fuck you to Vinny, and she's going to tank the price.
Okay, well, if that's the case, then that's bad.
She's going to do it around 5K, but she also told me she's in contact with somebody who said that they're getting blueprints soon for this, and they're going to start selling the crowbars at like 2.5K each to ruin the market. I don't know how credible that is, but that's what she said. It could have just been like her trying to bargain with us.
Okay.
but I don't know, you know, until we see it, right?
And you said that it's 300 alu and 200 offcuts?
No, it's 200 aluminium and 100 offducts. So it's 300 mats. Basically, if you're buying four each, it's $1,200 to make the crowbar.
Yeah, so we just roughly say five each because people want to be dicks sometimes. So you're looking at 1,500, right?
Well, I'd say prices might be going down soon, but we'll see. We'll just call it five, yeah, 1,500.
Right. Okay.
For crowbar. So if you're doing 25, you know, $45,000 cost.
Right.
I guess, around there.
And your problem right now is materials.
Yeah. But I think it's too late to start pushing crowbars, man. We're beyond that.
No, you're not. You just need to stop fucking selling the blueprints. My guy might not be awake yet.
Oh, also Dex has a blueprint.
Where'd you get that from?
I gave it to him. He was gonna be the person I wanted to work with since Brandon turned me down. So I gave it to him. He was gonna talk to some buddies of his, see if we can work something out.
Right. He just gave it to him for free.
Well, I mean, he's an associate and he works close with Sonia. I worked with him. If he scans me, he scans me, you know. But I don't think he'll do that. But we'll see. He has been around and he's been dodging me though for like 12 hours.
Question. How much aloe and offcuts do you have at the moment?
Me personally, aloe tubes, I've only got 10 of.
You know how much Ivan has?
Offcuts. Quite a bit, I think.
He's not awake yet, though.
No, he's having a lie in tonight.
Okay. If you see him around, can you get him to give me a call?
Yeah, I know he's got everything for yours. He did try to give you a ring last night, but you'd already gone to bed.
Yeah, I had a bit of an early night last night.
Yeah. All right. Well, when he wakes up, I'll get him to ring you, alright?
Alright, thank you.
No worries.
Hey. Okay. Billy.
Yeah.
Listen to me when I say this shit to you, right? You're very new to this. Just relax. Stop. Slow down.
I'm good, man. I mean, it is what it is. It turns out how it turns out, right? I'm clearly being pressured by, you know, other people. I'm not wanting to move this fast. I wanted to be.
So you need to sack up and tell them no. Just stop. It's simple. Billy, you're the one who gets fucked up for this, not them.
Oh, I mean, I'm not, you know, they're selling it. I'm just giving it to them, basically, right?
You need to be smart about this, right? Because this is what we spoke about already, is people get too fucking eager and they do things and then they try and make money and then it fucks shit up and it just goes to shit, right? For everyone involved. Look at the fact that we can no longer just buy fucking crowbars.
I agree. I agree. I don't think it was done properly at all. I think it's fucked. And I honestly wish, you know, me and Brandon were able to work something out, because that it would have been beautiful, honestly. Because I'm tired of dealing with just a bunch of people who say they're businessmen and just don't give a fuck, right? It's just self-interest.
I mean, to be fair, you got people calling fucking randoms in the yellow pages.
Well, I mean,
that's some of the dumbest shit that I've fucking heard.
No, I 100%. I mean, everything was fine until, you know, they came around and it's like, Billy, what the fuck are you doing, man? Just show this shit. Get the cash, man. It's like a golden goose egg that you're sitting on. It's only good for so long. Which, I mean, they have a point. Like, the shit's gonna be valuable for a couple of days, and
yeah,
someone else,
yeah, will be, right? But what's better to you, the connects that you can make or the money?
I mean every connection, most of the connections I've made have been shit. Like, the only good ones are you and Brandon. you know, I've yet to be able to work with you guys in that, you know, fashion, I guess. Well, everybody else I've tried to work with, like, I get it, you know, I'm kind of a fucking clown sometimes, you know, fucking goofball moron. And I'm green to the city, so I don't expect anybody to bring me in, you know, throw me a bone or anything. But it's, you know, I've made mistakes. I could have played it smarter, but you got to take risks, and it's really difficult when you don't know people, you don't know their backgrounds, and you're new. You know, so you got to take a chance. Sometimes it's going to work, sometimes it's not. If I don't take those chances, I'm just a fucking tow truck driver, right?
Can you do me a solid, Billy?
Yeah.
Next time you're thinking about going into business with someone, can you just run their name by me? So I can tell you whether or not it's fucking stupid.
Sonia said the same thing to me.
Yeah, I can tell you, as you saw, but with calling people in the yellow pages, it was a dumb idea, right? Yeah. It's a dumb idea. At Dex is gonna fucking use and abuse you. Simple as that, right? Because what you're doing, right, is when you're doing these things with where you're at the moment, right? And then you've got people that you're shooting up for that are quite well connected, right? And you go for them. They don't give a fuck about you, Billy. They're just gonna take what they want from you, and then it just furthers them, right? Someone like myself, for example, I couldn't give a fuck about making money, Billy. If I can put you in contact with someone else that will fucking help you with actually pushing out these crowbars, and they're actually business-minded, know what the fuck they're doing, then I'm just going to pass you on to them so you can do that. I could sit there and middleman you all I fucking want, make bank out of you. I don't give a fuck about that, Billy. Why? Because if I turn around and say to this person, hey, I got someone that has a blueprint for a crowbar that's looking for someone to work with them. However, they need someone with materials and they want to go into partnership with it. Then that works for both of you and him. And then in the long run, me, because I've made that connection for you two. Right? Me, I give a fuck more about keeping people moving and getting the connections. Right? I already have the connect with the other person. However, all it does is just strengthen that shit.
Yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, you know, connections take a little bit of time, and, you know, this is a little time sensitive, right? And a lot of people wanted to make rash decisions. But, you know, I should have just done nothing. But if I did nothing, I might have regretted it later. I don't know. You know, I feel like I'm going to regret it later no matter what I did in that situation. I'm not going to lie. I just sat there and I stewed for hours just thinking, like, okay, well, you know, if I go this approach, you know, this could happen. And it was a mental nightmare. And I got tired of just fucking overanalyzing it. Because every which way I thought I'd move, it was just horse shit.
Yeah.
So I said, fuck it. Just go with it. Deal with the consequences.
Oh, fuck's sake, Billy.
I know. I'm a fucking moron. But, I mean, my plan is basically, you know, I need to somehow sever ties with the people I live with and stop working with them.
Well, you don't need to sever ties with them. You just tell them, I'm no longer fucking doing this.
Yeah.
Even if you have to turn around and say, someone's threatened my life for doing this, I'm not doing this anymore.
I'm fucking psychopaths, man. I don't know if I want to fucking live in the same house as them, right?
Okay, well, that's its own thing. I mean, you're the one who fucking owns the house, right?
Yeah, but I'm not going to screw anybody over.
I'm not telling you, just, you'd never do that, right? I fucking can't stand people who do that. I will never tell you to screw someone over doing that shit, right? What I'm saying is you're the one who's now in the fucking thick of it because you're living in a house with them, right? And you are the clean guy. Yeah. Being the clean guy is never fucking fun because you always get fucking used and abused, right? How it is. So how much money did you put into the house? Of your own money.
65,000 cash and then two loans for 15,000 each, so 95,000 total.
Who did you get? Why did you get loans?
Well, they were impatient, and you know, they wanted to take out loans. So
I took
out some loans. They took out some loans.
Oh my god! Okay.
We got, you know, equity investors. I know they're fucking idiots.
Holy fuck! You are so in fucking deep, Billy. Jesus.
I mean, I can pay the loans back, no problem. I mean, you know, my loans are covered, and the ones in my name, I can pay those back now if I want.
Yeah, but you're also fucking 95k deep in the house. How many people do you have in the house?
We limited it to, well, this is where it gets a little complicated. I'm not sure I could divulge entirely all that information.
I just care about a number. That's it.
Okay. Well,
so I know how deep you are in this and the different portions. How many people are involved in owning a part of that house? Please don't make me throw you off this fucking truck.
So there's three of us.
Okay.
With the majority, and then
the other ones are like the loans. Somebody with
the loans don't count towards equity. That's just, you know, cash. But equity wise, I think we're looking at 3-4 majority shareholders, and then, like, you know, a couple small, like, here's 6,000 blah 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 that we're just gonna buy out.
Okay, that's not too bad. I was expecting for you to say like fucking 8 to 10 people.
No, I mean, it was a shit show getting the money together. Absolute shit show.
So they're never going to be able to buy you out of the house. You essentially have to buy them out of there.
Yeah,
and I hope they take the buyout.
Sell it. I don't know how that works, to be honest. I'll have to look into it. But I'm not too worried about that, you know. It'd be nice to, like, have something else going on, you know, away from that, but something quieter, you know, something more relaxed, people who are smart and not chaotic.
Okay, so how do we fix your problem? Right, so Billy, first thing you do is you stop selling blueprints, right? Now, the third person that's going to be getting the blueprint, are they usually around in this storm or the previous storm?
You know, I have nothing to do with that sale, so I don't know. They just said that there's somebody that wanted another one tomorrow, so I'm not sure.
I'm guessing that would be previous storm then. Not too bad.
Yeah, maybe.
Means that you need people that can do crowbars in this storm.
Well, I mean, you're talking about blueprint, right?
I'm talking about selling crowbars with you, not selling blueprints. Because you're going to stop selling blueprints, right, Billy?
I mean, if I'm going in on a crowbar deal with somebody, then yeah, I'm not going to sell blueprints. That's the whole thing, is I had to choose whether I flood the market with blueprints and not be able to sell crowbars, or if I sell crowbars and, you know, vice versa. You get it, right? But I'd rather sell crowbars, make the connections, meet people, make less money. You know, this is what I wanted. What Brandon sold me on, it was beautiful, man. It just, he didn't feel comfortable with a good fit because I'm a fucking moron.
You have to have done something to have pissed him off.
I don't know. You know how he is. He looks for a little thing. He's like, strike one, Billy. Strike two, Billy. You know, I don't know if he's fucking with me or not. And, you know, half the time I'm fucking with him too, and it's like, I don't know if he actually knows if I'm fucking with him, and I don't know.
I'm sure. So there's nothing you can rack your head with what you did.
I mean, he got upset with a phone call that I had with a friend of mine. I mean, he got really pissed about that. Maybe it was that. And then he had a meeting to go to that he wanted to go to, and you know, I said, okay, well, I get it. You know, you might not want me there because you're, you know, the sales pitch guy and, you know, they're comfortable with you. But are we 50-50 on this or are you going to keep me on the outside? Because I want to be included, you know. I don't want to feel like we're partners and then just be the guy in the corner, basically. Because that's not what I'm in for it for. So, you know, I made that pretty clear. So, I was a little, you know, over pushy and I just, you know, got a little, you know, pretend to be a little sad just to guilt trip a little bit, but I didn't really give a fuck, you know. So I don't know if it was that, maybe the phone call. It could have been, you know, a couple of different things.
Yeah. Okay.
I wonder if he's around, though. I tried calling him earlier.
Yeah, I tried calling him, too.
Yo, what's good, man?
Hey, question. Did you guys sort out your bench yet?
Yeah.
Who's running materials for you?
I don't know. I think Dom and Louie got them all.
Yeah. Have you guys got a decent amount at the moment?
Computer. I don't think so.
Yeah.
I have no idea. You'd have to ask Louie or Dom. What? Maybe KJ would know.
Yeah, he's not awake yet. I was hoping he was going to be awake, but he's not.
I put down the rest of the plants to be a master grower, so when I harvest those in a couple hours. Yeah. So I go on the up and up.
If you
star on the rise.
If you see him around, just tell him to give me a call, alright?
Okay.
Never he works up. Alright. Come on. Awake. Okay. Right. See, here's the thing, Billy, right? Is I want to put you in connection with someone that will help you, like I said, right? I don't give a fuck about it. I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to be your partner and do it all and that kind of shit. I don't care. The only thing that I would ever request from you is a blueprint for personal use. That's it. Right? But for you, you need to get in connection with these people that can help you if shit starts going sideways. And you need to stop selling the fucking blueprints for the love of fuck. Because all that does is just fuck you up too. Now, there's two people I have in mind. One, both I'm very close with. One is going to be good for doing it on the streets. The other one is going to be good for doing it via business. So I need to work out if I want to put you in contact with both or one. Problem being is you don't want them competing with each other, right? You want them to be kind of setting it and being like, either you can get from us or you can get from here. Catch my drift? Because then all it does is it puts that net out wider and you know that they're not going to be fucking each other over. Let me throw a feeler out real quick.
Okay.
Motherfucker's still in his meeting. When he's out of his meeting, he said he'd give me a call in 5. When he's out of his meeting, I'll talk to the one for the business. The other one's not awake yet and probably wake up in a few hours, I assume.
Okay.
But when doing this stuff, you kind of need to be honest with them, right? And say, if I'm going into business with you, I'm just letting you know that there is someone else involved that is handling more of the street side of things.
Okay. So it'd be, you know, me with two other people, right? And they'd be opposite time zones, most likely.
Yes and no. Okay. There'd be some overlap to it, right? However, the way you look at it and you talk to people is saying this is more for the street kind of shit, but doors you can advertise on the on like business saying, hey, we're now selling crowbars as well. So you got that side covered, but then the street one is going to be more about under the table. Now the safety net for you is more the street side, right? Because if someone's fucking up with where they're getting these fucking the blueprints from and that kind of shit, then that's where the issues will be. But then you also need to make sure both these people are trustworthy, which I can vouch for both of them, that they're not going to fuck around, right? Because it's very easy to go into business with someone, i.e. someone who says, I'll help you with the lockpick thing, and you make fucking nothing out of it, Billy. You dumb bitch.
What do you mean?
Oh, did he give you money yet?
I mean, we went half on it, but I mean, I honestly don't think he's producing lockpicks, man. I assume he's making shit on the side for his boys, you know, but I don't think his shop's actually making lockpicks and selling them, right?
I reckon he uses...
Well, I mean, not that I've, you know, heard of, but if you hear anything, you know, let me know. But, yeah, I mean, I'm pretty sure I'm scammed on that. You know, if I eat the loss, I eat the loss, but, you know, I'm going to hound him here and there to get enough lockpicks, basically, to, you know, try and get my share of the money back.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we'll see, you know, and if I get scammed, then I'll fucking blow up his shop, you know, later down the line or some bullshit. I don't fucking know.
I think this is probably going to be your best bet of not getting yourself fucked up. Kind of wish Brandon was here so I could talk to him, but it's fucking not. Sounds like you already pissed him off.
I don't know if he's mad, he just decided it wasn't his best interest. Maybe he just wanted to avoid shit shows like this, right?
The other person should be awake in about half hour. Okay. Are you okay with doing it this way then, Billy?
I mean, what, I just sell them the blueprint and they make crowbars? Is that...
Well, it's either that or you do something similar to Vinny, but you actually make money back.
What do you mean, make?
So, right, here's the thing. Blueprint costs you 5,700, right? You can make 25 at fucking... So what's... We worked it out to be 1,500 materials, right? So that's 37,500. Remember that.
Okay.
37,500, right?
Yep.
Right. So if they sell all 25 crowbars at 5,000, that's 87.5, right? So 43,750 each.
Okay.
Right. Now, that's not inclusive. Yeah. That's not inclusive of you paying for that blueprint, right? So if you 5,725 to 2,850. So total raw that you'll get back if you can sell every crowbar for $5,000 is going to be just over 40 grand. So almost 41 grand.
Each. Yeah, I mean, that's a lot for, you know.
Now, if
I'm more than happy with that, yeah.
If you have two people doing that, right, then you know, it's pretty fucking easy money. Now, the best thing about doing it for a shop is you talk to one person in that shop, and then they don't pass on your details to anyone else in the shop, right? That's not too much more of the connection side. That's just a way that if someone wants to come into a business and buy one, and they do all the advertising, all the hard work, and they just give you the money, it's easy. The street person is more the connect, right? It's looking after your best interest here when it comes down to it, because anyone that fucks with you now fucks with their money. So you have the potential to be making decent money out of this if you say we'll go halves in the blueprint. You don't have to pay me anything more, but each time you sell one, then you give me a kickback of 2.5 grand. And you sell them for 5K. Right?
Yeah. I mean, that's good. You know, I don't have to source material. I just sit back and collect money. Yeah.
On, sorry, not 2.5K. Whatever it is, less the fucking 1,500. So, what's that? 1,750 per crowbar, right? Less the materials.
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah. Right. So they do that. They give you 1,750 per crowbar that they make and they give to people. They get half as well. You both split the cost of what the materials would be. If they find the materials fucking cheaper, or if they get the materials themselves, they get bonus money out of it, right? Who gives a fuck? Right? You're not having to worry about the materials. You're not having to worry about the sales or anything like that. All you're doing is just getting something back.
Yeah.
That works in your favor because it's less work for you to do. However, the only risk that you've got is that you're putting your faith in someone else that you don't really know right now, right? But honestly, the risk of fucking the cost of half a blueprint is really too much, right? But the people I'm talking to wouldn't fuck you over that. So, I reckon that's probably your best way to do it. Again, I make fucking nothing out of this. This is to benefit you, Billy, and for you to stop doing stupid things. Are we clear?
Yeah, I mean we're good. I mean if it's basically what me and Brandon cooked up, you know. But I'm for it, you know, if they're interested, obviously. But I'm
happy. If I find out that you're selling more blueprints and you're fucking this shit up though, Billy, I swear to God.
Well, if I have this deal, man, I'm not gonna be selling blueprints. Like I have no reason to.
Can answer that. I'm still just waiting for this other guy to call.
Hey, what's going on? Good. I haven't made it to bank yet. I've just been, you know, in a meeting for a little while. Okay, yeah, no worries. I'll take care of it soon. Okay. Yeah, bye.
You need to transfer someone money?
Yeah, I'm just gonna pay off one of the loans. Apparently, there's some cars in the city now, and the loan guy wants to free up.
Oh, I'm waiting for this call. We'll go to a bank.
Sorry, what did you say?
I said, while I'm waiting for this call, we'll go to a bank. So you can sort that shit out and not have to worry about someone fucking wanting to stab you for owing money.
No, he's not gonna stab me. You know, the loan has a term, and I'm paying it back before, you know, the term's even up.
Yeah, but if you're paying back quickly and that kind of shit kind of helps sometimes in the future, you know?
100%.
If you tell someone you're going to pay them money, then we'll just go do it and hit the bank up and it's done. It helps them.
Yeah.
Unless it's a complete idiot that it doesn't fucking matter and they're going to be no benefit to you. Billy, you need to start thinking smarter. A fucking donut.
I wore a donut sweatshirt the other day.
Yeah, you are a fucking donut.
Well, I mean, I'm a lemon, okay? That's what the lemon sweatshirt was for.
No, you're not just a lemon. You're a fucking lemon flavored donut.
Oh shit, that's. Yeah. You don't mean that.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't fucking take it back.
No, because you're a dumb fuck getting people to fucking call on the Yellow Pages!
You know, just it makes the city alive. It makes the city feel alive, you know?
No, well, you're gonna fucking feel super dead soon.
Yeah, I, you know, I know. I'm well aware of, you know, what the repercussions were or are going to be.
You go there, I'm going across the street for fuel. What? Ah! Right. Why is Reggie always a fucking daycare? Helping fucking lemons. Nah, that piqued your interest.
I just walked away from the meeting. I just walked away from it. Okay. It's like talking to Silas. They just go around in circles.
Luca.
Yeah.
What is one thing that everyone wants in the city right now?
I don't know. Guns.
Other than guns. Or money. There's a particular item that a lot of people want.
Cars, bikes. Fuck knows. What
gives
else?
You access to something?
A crowbar?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, mine broke just like yesterday.
Now, do you all have someone that is helping you with that? At your business?
No, we were the only people that had a crowbar, like one of the only few people in the city that had a crowbar, because we got ours for day one, so and we haven't talked to Vinny or anything like that, or Moses or whatever.
Okay, so you guys are running your mechanic shop, right?
Yeah.
What if there was a way, you could go into a partnership with someone and it would aid you in making crowbars and then selling.
It depends on who it is, and it depends on what every single person a part of this business says, because they all have a say and an equal say.
Mm-hmm. I have a feeling that most people won't say no to that, right?
Probably not.
Hmm.
Bill for it.
Right. Okay, so I'm just acting as a facilitator to introduce people, and you were one of the people that I figured might benefit from a partnership with this person.
Right.
Essentially, what I'm looking at is you and the person would go into a equal 50-50 on it. And you split the cost of the blueprint, and then after the item's made, you go 50-50 in the profit from it.
Okay, is there a catch?
No. This person is just looking for someone that can actually help facilitate this business. The only slight thing that would need to be made aware is they will be working with another person, which isn't a business, is dealing with like street shit.
What do you mean, like street shit?
Like dealing with like other criminals and that kind of shit, right?
I mean, that is what it is, right?
Yeah.
You just
push
however you push, but we don't get a cut from that, do we?
No, so you just don't get a cut because they'll just basically have their own separate partnerships, right? Essentially what it is those both sides are aware that they're both working with the same person, so they're not competing. It's just a set. You sell them for $5,000, right?
Okay.
So that way it's not competing, but the two people won't really have that much crossover.
So wait, why is this person so secretive? Because so there isn't crossover?
No, it's so you know who the person is, the other person that's selling. I'm saying there's no crossover. Okay. Right, so it means that you guys have your own little fucking set time that the majority of you guys are around, and they have a set time where they've got the majority of them around. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Kind of like working opposite to each other, but you guys are aware of each other and you guys keep the market price the same as each other.
Gotcha. So is it, do they have a house and a table and stuff like that to be able to craft it?
Well, that was going to be my question is, do you guys have that?
Possibly.
Okay, because what it would be is it's going to be a little bit more of an honor system here, right? Is
right.
That you guys would be handling the blueprint itself after paying for half, and the person buying it pays for the other half, and then you guys just give them kickbacks from it.
So wait, are they buying the blueprint or do they have it?
They can buy them.
Okay. How much is the blueprint?
50-50? So it would be... Fuck, give me a second. Boom. 28.50 each.
28k or 2,800?
2,850.
It's a blueprint so quick, cheap.
Because you can only make a certain amount from them. Hence why I'm putting yourself and the other people in contact with said person, so it can be an ongoing business relationship. I've got no stake in this claim. I couldn't give two flying fucks about the claim. All I'm doing is just trying to facilitate it.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, I can bring it up. I got Raven, Divine, Owen, Molten all behind me, so.
Well, have a chat to them. Let me know. So obviously, whatever it costs for the materials, because I'm sure you guys have material runners that deal with that shit, right? So whatever.
It's fucking horrible.
Well, whatever it costs for the materials is both parties go half in it, right? So that gets split from whatever it's made from the crowbar. And then whatever's left over, you go 50-50 in that.
So wait, we have to get all the materials, make the crowbar, and then 50-50.
Yes. But the money that comes from that, so they're essentially paying for the materials, right?
Right, okay. So wait, they buy materials off us as well then?
Well, they're not making them. You're making... Okay, so let me put it this way, right? If you were to buy, say, the materials for it, you're looking at 1,500, right? If that's at 5 per, right?
Okay.
Right, so you're looking at 1,500. So both sides would absorb a $750 cost on that. But then that comes out of the crowbar that's sold. And the leftovers from there goes as a 50-50. So that way you guys aren't getting fucked out of it, and they're not getting fucked out of it.
Okay, all right. Let them know. Probably going to have to explain this to someone way better with numbers and stuff like that.
Okay.
I'm a dumb fuck.
Yeah, well, I've figured as much now that I'm trying to explain it to you. Okay. Well, I mean, if you want to get them to call me, I can talk. And then if it's something that we're looking at doing, then I can do the introduction between yourself and the other person. And then you guys can hash it out. Okay. Have a chat to them first, see if it's something they're interested in, and then I'll bring the person down with me.
Sure. All right. I'll give you a call in a minute then and let you know. Okay.
All right. Bye. All right.
In a bit.
Okay. So that one looks like it might be good. We'll see what they say.
Okay.
Just is gonna have a chat to the other ones at the business at the moment.
Yeah, no worries.
And then call me back if they want to discuss it further, and we can go down there and have a chat with them and see what they say. And the other person, when they wake up, I'll have a chat to them, explain it to them as well. Basically, this is a way that you don't have to worry about getting materials, right?
Yeah, I mean, I'm good with that.
Basically, it's just, you know, passive income for you.
So what is it you do, Reggie? You just tow truck drive? You don't care about money? What do you care about?
The majority of my life, I've been an advisor of sorts for people. Stop people from doing dumb things.
Do you usually succeed?
Yes. Why people listen to me. I was the founder of one of the largest gangs before the economic crash.
A founder?
Correct.
Holy shit. Okay. Damn. The fuck you doing hanging out with me?
I don't know. Apparently, I keep fucking running daycares for the whole of my life.
Jesus. Just keep picking up strays, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. I can't just leave them on the fucking street. Listen, like I said, Billy, I could easily just fucking make money off your back, right? And yeah, I'm stupid for not doing it. But it's not my deal, right? I don't give a fuck about that. I can sit there and make money as much as I fucking want. And the group of people that I am with at the moment is, I've made easily the most amount of money out of all of them. Right? But it's, people need to learn the money isn't everything. Because money is going to come and go, right? It's the connects you want to keep. How I literally built my name from fucking nothing. Now anyone with any kind of fucking credibility in the city knows who Reggie is. Some people from time to time still make the stupid mistake of trying to threaten me, and then they work out quickly it's a bad idea. There's one thing that people always fail to remember, is there's always someone scarier out there than you. I am by far not the scariest person, but I'm also not someone to be fucked with. I built my name by my fucking self. Didn't do it off the back of a fucking gang or anything like that. Did everything I did from myself. Very rare that you find someone like that, Billy. Someone's always got to get a leg up from someone else. I don't do that shit.
No one threw you a bone?
Oh, I worked hard for everything I had. I used to be part of an MC, right? Then we, was a sergeant at arms. It basically was the VP, because there was none, right? So from there, we decided to dissolve that. Then I went off on my own. Was doing mechanic work as well. Started building up connects from there. Started gun running for people. Started running drugs. All that kind of shit. ended up, like I told you before, being a mercenary for hire. Someone's in a fucking gang war and they need someone. They call me. I black out. I go help them. I'd never ask for a fucking cent for it. Why? Because money isn't what you need. You help them in a time of need like that. Anytime someone fucks with you, they will help you. So then you get all these connections from there. Then I was a lawyer. Helped plenty of people doing that. Never took a cent for being a lawyer. Unless I had to do with business stuff because I fucking hated business shit. Never took a cent from any of the court cases that had to do that. Was business shit different because I fucking hate that shit, right? So I've helped all these people out while I was a lawyer. Again, connections. Don't fuck with my lawyer. And from there, ended up going into the Vargos. Made the Vargos bank. Millions. Ran the whole fucking... the whole meth game. That had to do with anything to do with the public lab. And no one was cooking in there without me knowing. Executed people who did it without me saying that they could. Advised a lot of people on what to do. Left that, went into another gang called Seaside that I founded. Ended it being practically the fucking third in charge of it, right? Was an advisor for everything. Was also a judge at time. Even though I was in a gang, I was still a lawyer.
Judge?
I was just still in a gang while I was a judge.
What the fuck?
Billy, I've done a lot of things in the years that I have been in this city. A lot of things. Every time, all they've done is just build more connects and strengthen who I am in the city. It's not something that was quick. This is like fucking 4 years of shit that I've gone through. And every time, all I do is just keep building myself up. And I got a lot of the connects that I have because I don't care about money. I made the Vargos all that money with all the fucking meth that I was cooking. I made fuck all myself. Lived a wild ass life, Billy. And I could have made bank every fucking time for myself, but I don't. Because money doesn't give you everything. People remember when you help them. So maybe now you're understanding a little bit more about the person that I am.
Yeah. No, I get you. You're a very rare breed, though. I can't imagine there's a whole lot of Reggies out there.
There's fucking not. There is not. Like I said, every cunt wants to get a fucking leg up on you in the city. Up to you to sift through which ones those are. I've only asked you for fucking one thing. It's probably the only time that you'll ever fucking hear from me ask for something. Because I don't like being in people's pocket, if you get what I mean, right? I don't like loaning things from people. I don't like fucking handouts or anything. So what I'm doing currently is working to get you into a position that will better you, then thus means that I have technically helped you, so thus you help me. Catch my drift? I've been very upfront about it.
Yeah, I got you.
So we'll see what these people say. I think that if you can work with both of them, it'll be really good for you, because one that does the streets is a really good salesperson.
Okay.
And they have been moving shit for the majority of their life. quite well connected themselves. The other one's a business. The business is run by ex-cops. So ain't no one gonna fuck with them, because they're very lethal in their own right.
Ex-cops.
Shouldn't scare you, Billy. These ones ain't got anything to fucking lose, and they're very smart with what they do. However, they're also going to protect where they get their money from too.
Fucking burnt right now, so I my apologies for not being very talkative to you, being receptive. I'm hearing you though.
How long have you been awake for, Billy?
Well, you know, I don't know, to be honest. It was like a couple naps here and there, but pretty long time, you know, because timetable's brief on this one. There's a lot going on, right?
On that crackhead fucking energy?
Well, kinda. I mean, to be honest, I only came around this storm to try and talk to you and you know, a couple other people that I, you know, intended on selling blueprints to, because I knew they were in this time.
No more blueprint selling.
No more blueprint selling. But I mean, you know, just know there's one extra one, you know, that my pals are hanging on to, in case, you know, they were gonna do something when I'm not around. And then there's the one that Dex is holding, right? So I don't know what he's gonna do with that one. I got a feeling it's not coming back to me, just because he's been dodging me for like the last 12 hours. But you know, I won't get any more.
The fuck is C4 Enterprises?
I don't know. Some company name that Sonya came up with.
See, Kirk has it as well.
Yeah, it's they're trying to get the name out there, right?
Well, you see, it's just so has Sonya been advertising it too?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Pretty much people already know about you then. All right.
Yeah, I told him I didn't really want to put C4 in there just because the association.
Yeah. Right?
But, you know.
Yeah. Should probably change that there, pal. All
right.
Oh, you should probably, you know, especially if Jordan wants to stab whoever's been. Yep. Yep.
I mean, who is this Jordan guy? Like, why? What does he care?
Is a part of a gang.
Make it quick. I can't talk right now. No, I'm just in a meeting. That's all. I'm sorry. Okay. All right. Bye. This fucking guy, man. He calls just to talk to me for like 10-15 minutes at a time on the phone. He just, I don't know, he sends me like memes and shit too, just all the time.
Maybe he's a serial killer. He's basically what you are to Brandon.
Yeah, but I guess, you know, I'm seeing it in his perspective now, yeah.
I gotta think about a drink. I just need to grab a drink real quick.